kind of crawling along here in heavy traffic. It's December 6th, about an hour past sunset at 6 o'clock. And it's just the start of a snowstorm. We're supposed to get about 2 feet of snow over the next couple days. And head to our flying site. Oh, here's some cars in the ditch, sliding around, little fender benders. And guess where I'm heading? I'm heading to our flying site to go flying. Alright, we're on the road. Going to check out a new flying site. Alright, so you had to know there was a little twist to this. We are experimenting with heading to the local golf dome. We got permission to try out some scooter towing in the dome. At first it seems like a crazy idea, but it's really a perfect venue in theory for intro lessons. I mean, after all, we are after zero wind conditions for our first day students. So for the trial, just my fellow instructor, Ryan, myself, and one of our students went into the dome just to test our theories out. We only had about 225 feet of field to use, so we weren't too sure just how well it would work. So moments after the last golfer was done with the driving range, we squeaked our big Wills Wing Condor 330 through the mezzanine, which cuts some of the usable space of the dome down, and got underway. To take the first crack at doing this. As far as I know, I've never heard of any indoor hang gliding before, so I had to take the first shot at it. We kind of held back with a little bit more tension than we usually do with our students in hopes to get kind of slingshot into the air. Worked pretty good. I wouldn't want to shoot students up that quick. But that was the first flight there, and it worked pretty well. This is the second one. We got the tensions down a little bit better just to make the best use of the field that we have. I took about four flights before letting Ryan take a shot at it. This is Ryan's first flight here. He's about 50 pounds heavier than me. A lot more momentum, got him up a tad bit high. And as you can see, we used up 100% of our field. The second flight was much better. Still used up 100% of the field though. Then we figured it was time for student Nick to give it a go. He was itching to give it a shot. We found we only had about a good second or two of pulling once they were off the ground before we had to kill the throttle to let them glide in to land. Then we let the employees give it a crack. They had no idea we were even coming in that night, so these are their very first lessons to guys that never even entertained doing any hang gliding. They were a big help opening the dome for us and staying late, so we appreciate their efforts. as you can see, they're not perfect flights, but these are our typical first timers. We ended up getting 14 toes in just over an hour, and I figure we could be a little bit more efficient with that. Obviously, no one's even releasing from the tow line, so all they had to do was walk backwards a couple hundred feet, and with the tow line still attached, we're ready to fly again. We think it's a pretty good venue to continue our training throughout the winter. Good repetition for potential students. And yeah, we're gonna see where it takes us. Should be fun.